Okay, me reading an absolutely disgusting Harry Potter fanfiction entitled Hermione's Furry Little Problem. It was written by Gandalf's Beard. And the basic premise is that Hermione has used Polyjuice Potion and she is half turned into a cat and sexual things ensue. Okay, yeah, and there are some warnings for anybody who wants to read this. They are thus, this fanfiction contains the following. Abuse/torture, adult themes, extreme sexual situations, rape, strong language, strong violence, and the best one, underage sex. So yes, this is your final chance to back out. It is in fact 18+. In fact, it's not even just 18+. You don't even want to watch this at all. Anyway, let's begin. Hedwig hooted happily when Harry let her out of the cage and opened his window for her. Hermione leaned against Harry with her arms and fluffy tail curled around him as they watched Hedwig soar into the night sky, silhouetted briefly against the full moon. Harry felt Hermione's lips press against his cheek. He turned his face and gazed soulfully into her golden brown eyes. So it's not too bad so far. It's kind of nice. Harry returned Hermione's kisses. This is where it goes downhill. And they became increasingly heated. His hand slipped under Hermione's woolly jersey and cupped her breasts, feeling her hardening nipples pressing into his palms through the fabric of her shirt. They broke apart and Harry grinned as Hermione wriggled out of her jeans and panties and pulled her sweater and t-shirt over her head. Hermione stood there completely naked. Her furry tail danced in the moonlight streaming into Harry's bedroom, and her furry ears flattened as she purred in excitement and began to kiss him again. Without another thought, a delighted Harry swept a giggling Hermione off her feet and carried her to his tiny little bed before hurriedly tugging off his own clothes. He had never imagined that he might ever have a girl in his bed at number 4 Privet Drive, and the fact that it was Hermione had Harry more erect than he could have ever thought possible. He pushed apart Hermione's legs and began kissing the insides of her thighs as he clambered onto the squeaking bed. Harry's kisses gradually moved upward, and his tongue darted out, leaving a wet trail up her inner thighs as he closed in on Hermione's labia, target spotted. The sensation between her legs was driving Hermione crazy already, and her purring became more rapid. She felt herself gasping even before Harry's tongue entered her. Hermione meowed and wrapped her thighs around Harry's head as he nibbled and licked her clitoris. Harry was glad that he remembered to cast a muffliatio spell around his room. I'm sorry, I lost my... Okay. Then Harry began to slather his tongue across her bare pubic mound. So John, help me. No, I don't... I can read it all. Okay. Let's see. Hermione's abdomen rippled as he licked his way up to her belly button. His fingers tweaked her smallest pair of nipples, as if she has multiple pairs of nipples, as his tongue pushed into the indentation. Then he sucked each nipple before moving up to the next pair. Oh my god, she does have multiple pairs of nipples. What the hell? Oh my god. Okay. Little shocks of pleasure surged from every place Harry's tongue and fingers touched Hermione, and her muse grew louder as she ran her fingers through Harry's thick black hair. She felt his hands cup her lower pair of breasts and his lips encircle each nipple and give them a suck. Finally, he reached her first pair of breasts and gently squeezed them, tenderly biting those nipples. Harry took his time on them. He could feel Hermione's wet slit spasm against his bare stomach, and she knew... Fuck. Do I have to? Do I have to? Your idea, oh my god. Against her.
Well, point to where you are with your cursor. I'll take over.
No, I got this. I got this. I can do
you
it.
You feel Hermione's wet slits.
No, listen. This it won't show up on the recording. John, it won't show up on the recording. I'm going to have to cut out some dial. Okay, but here we go. He could feel Hermione's wet slits spasm against his bare stomach, and she knew she was almost ready. He looked up at her face and saw Hermione biting her lower lip. Her eyes closed as she moaned loudly, and her ears flattened. Unable to hold back any longer himself, Harry pushed his hands under Hermione's bottom and entered her, his erection filling her completely in one go. Harry began kissing her face, and his own teeth replaced Hermione's on her bottom lip as he began to thrust his penis inside of her hard and fast. Hermione's tail curled around Harry's buttocks and pulled him in deeper. I can't. She was beginning to lose it, and wave after wave of pleasure coursed through her body. Hermione exploded into bliss with a loud yowl. The contractions around Harry's penis were too much for him to hold off, and he groaned as he stiffened and burst, filling Hermione with semen. Sparks of magic flew everywhere, knocking over his lamp, blasting books and Dudley. Oh my god, this is in Dudley's house. This is in Dudley's room. Blasting books and Dudley's old toys off shelves. Harry collapsed on top of Hermione, panting rapidly, feeling her breasts and nipples pressed into his sweaty torso. Sweaty torso. As his penis jerked several more times inside of her. Oh boy. After several minutes on top of Hermione, Harry was still too dazed to notice that she was rolling him onto his back. Moments later, through blurry eyes, Harry saw Hermione's tabby tail waving, and her dripping vulva hovering above his face, her knees on either side of his head. God. He gasped when he felt her lips wrapped around his softening penis and stiffened again. Hi, Cody.
I didn't want to go to sleep yet.
Yeah, well, we're doing this now, so get ready for a little bit more of a ride before I'm done. Let's restart that sentence. He gasped when he felt her lips wrap around his softening penis, and he stiffened again instantly. He peered down between her thighs at her bouncing breasts as her chin bobbed up and down his erection. Hermione's rough cat tongue wrapped around his penis as she sucked. Harry couldn't take it anymore, and he erupted again, squirting load after load into Hermione's throat. Oh, God. As she swallowed. After swallowing as much as she could, Hermione backed off, gasping for breath as Harry continued to ejaculate onto her face and hair. What?
There's a bee in my room.
Oh, man. There's a bee in his room. When Harry's penis finished twitching, Hermione climbed off the bed. The young couple looked at each other and burst out laughing. Harry's catgirl wife had his semen dripping in rivulets from her face, and his own face had splotches of his own semen on it, which had seeped... I'm so close. Which had seeped from her labia. There's a loud... Okay, this is... It's over. It's over.
Continue.
There's a loud cracking sound and a naked pair of teenagers. Teenagers covered in bodily fluids both shrieked. Hermione leapt onto the bed with Harry, her fur all on end. Dobby? What the bloody hell are you doing here? A mortified Harry yelled as he vainly tried to pull a bit of cover over himself and Hermione. Dobby's large eyes grew even larger, bigger, bulging out of his head. He clasped both hands over his mouth in horror at the scene, realizing that he had just intruded on an intimate moment between two children. Without another word, he immediately slammed his own head into the floor before Harry and Hermione could stop him. Oh my god. I am very glad... That is over. Oh my god.
His softening penis. And it instantly became hard again.
Oh god. John, this was a bad idea.